It is Sunday, August 12, 2012, and I'd like to demonstrate for you RebelROM version 1.1. RebelROM is a sense-based ROM with as much of sense removed as possible, giving the ROM a very AOSP feel. As you can see right out of the box, this is not the Rosie or the HTC Sense launcher, but this is Apex launcher, which is very similar to the AOSP launcher with a bunch of extra features and customizations available. So before we dive in, let's take a look at the versions of the software that come in this ROM. So you can see Android version 4.0.3, baseband or radio version 0.18c, and kernel version 3.0.8. So although this looks like AOSP, there are a bunch of popular HTC One X modifications to this ROM that are very handy. For example, up here on the top, you can see, or you may be able to see, there's a number in the battery indicator that says the percentage remaining, which is only 18% at this point, so better go quickly. There's also the key remap, so if you press the recent tasks key, instead of bringing up the recent tasks, it brings up the menu. However, you can still get to the recent tasks by pressing and holding the recent tasks button. Problem is, it also brings up Google search behind it, which is a bug that I'm sure will be fixed in the future. Pressing and holding the home key brings up Google Voice. And I'll launch another app to show you what happens. When you press and hold the back key, it actually kills the foreground application. So let's look at some of the other customizations. If you swipe down from the top, you'll notice this brings up the notification tray like you're used to, but it also has the quick settings option here at the bottom, which allows you to toggle a bunch of settings on the phone, such as brightness, Wi-Fi, control the volumes, silent, turn on the flashlight, which just turns on the camera flash, and other features. You'll also notice it's a very nice theme. I really like these colors, the blue and the black. I find that white or whiter themes just scream in your face at night, so I really like having black as the background. And it also looks really nice on the black curvature of the HTC One X. Another feature is the advanced power menu. So if you press and hold the power key, it brings up a menu as usual, but with a few extra options, such as the ability to take a screenshot, and also to toggle airplane mode, the mobile network, or to go between silent, vibrate, and non-silent mode. If you select restart, there are a few options here as well. The normal full reboot, as well as a hot reboot. You can reboot into recovery, which is really handy if you're flashing mods and ROMs. And also you can reboot into the bootloader. The core Droid tweaks have also been ported to this ROM, and it comes with an app called Nocturnal Tweaks. And you may have noticed there as well, the Jelly Bean transitions are also implemented in this ROM, so the screen's flying on and off the screen. Now in the core Droid tweaks, not all of them apply, such as the lock screen. You don't have the option of the Sense launch screen, and the whole Sense section is useless because there's no Sense. But one that I really like is the selecting the AOSP recent tasks. So just to remind you, the recent tasks, this is the sense based recent tasks where you swipe horizontally to do the, but I prefer the Android recent tasks. So let's select that. I will have to do a hot reboot and then we can see what that looks like. So now if we press and hold the recent tasks key, oh, there's no recent apps there, so let's start a few. Browser, people. There's a more vertical list here that you can swipe up and down, which I much prefer. So now I'd like to take a few moments and show you how I've customized RebelROM for myself. So this is how I have RebelROM set up for my daily driver. I've been using it for about 2 weeks and have customized it to the point where I'm very, very happy with it. The first customization is using Apex Launcher. This gives you features such as swipe gestures to bring up the notifications. And I also really like this theme that you can see has changed some of the icons and also gives you this cool background. If I go into Apex settings, you can see this theme is called Xperia. It's a free download from the Google Play Store, as well as the Jelly Bean HD theme, which is kind of cool too. The second customization is using HD widgets. So this widget up here, which is very similar to the Sense widgets, which are excellent, is part of HD widgets. It has the time, the weather, and the date. There are several other widgets that are part of HD widgets as well. One of them that I really like is this 5x5, which takes up a full screen. I like to set it to just the weather because I already have the time on another home screen. And then we can resize it. So very handy. And the final customization is I've installed the Beast Mode kernel version 2.1, which is the only custom kernel for the North American HTC One X at this point, and it allows me to overclock and underclock the CPU. So if I launch CPU Spy, you can see that it spent a little bit of time at 2106 megahertz, and the maximum in the stock HTC software is 1512. And has also spent some time at 192, which is one step below the minimum in stock, which is 384, and then a ton of time in deep sleep. And you can see down here at the bottom, Beast Mode kernel version 2.1. It's been great battery life and very solid. I haven't noticed at least any issues with it at all. So this is RebelROM version 1.1 by Team Nocturnal, and specifically user BPair96 on the XDA developer forums. Many thanks to producing this excellent ROM for us.